Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video guys, we'll be working on a vehicle made by General Motors. So if you have guys vehicles such as Chevy guys, GMC, Buick, even Cadillac, and you have any of the following three codes that you can see in the corner of the video guys, I'm talking about code P0013, P0014, or code guys P2091. Stay with us guys, we'll explain what causes these codes and how to fix it. We'll show you how we're going to scan the system, what we use, and if you need to buy any parts, you can find the link in the description of the video below for your vehicle guys, and you can see where we buy all our parts from. Now, quick introduction to the channel. We'll have more than 200 videos made on every car we get at the shop. Why? Because our mission is to save you guys as much money as we can. So please subscribe to the channel and like the video guys. Hopefully you will find the information helpful. So, we have a 2015 Chevy Cruze guys, engine light is on when we start the car, sometimes it starts a little bit harder, sometimes it doesn't idle right, sometimes it stalls guys, at the traffic light, stop light, you may notice that the engine is trying to stall and die on you. Okay, this is guys because one of the sensors is not working correctly and we'll explain which one, and if that sensor is not working, okay, your timing will not be correct for the vehicle, the variable timing will not be functioning right, and it can guys cause so many things. I'll explain that in a second. So you need to find guys, okay, your OBD port right here, and you just connect the scanner port, okay, right there. If you need to buy a good cheap scanner guys, check out the link in the description of the video below. This is amazing scanner that actually has a live data as well. So something like that, this one I always keep it in my vehicles guys. Why? Because it's very compact, it's not expensive, and if my engine light comes on, I can always scan the system and see what's wrong on the go. Live data makes things even way better. You can diagnose your system and see the parameters and find out what's wrong with your car. So if you experience any of these codes guys, what can happen actually? Okay, actually guys, you may notice decreased horsepower, reduced horsepower, increased fuel consumption, and the engine not running correctly. So we're going to click OBD now here. Okay, check it out now, it's loading. It should be any second. Okay, codes found to you guys. And let me show you how the engine light stays on. Okay, check it out now, engine light is just on guys. Okay, let me just zoom out a little bit all the time. I'll turn the light off a little bit, okay, so you can even see a little bit better that it just stays on. I'll rev the car up. It does rev up guys, but definitely the car sometimes it feels like it's stalling, especially on traffic stoplight. So I'm going to click yes here to erase previously stored data. Now we have three different computers that this gives you guys. Usually our codes are stored under the one that ends with an 8. But check each one of them. You can scan the codes in each of those divisions and see if you have an extra code there. For your vehicle it might be another one. So click read codes, stored codes, and something we're going to check, P0013B camshaft position actuator. We're going to explain what B means in a second. P2091B camshaft position actuator again. So what I do now, I go back and I click pending codes here, because under pending codes you may get some extra codes that can help you actually solve the problem. In our case we don't have anything, those are the two codes that we have. So what I'm going to do now guys, I'm going to go ahead and we'll turn the car off. I'll go outside and I'll show you what needs to be replaced guys, okay, to take care of these codes and turn your engine light off. So now guys, this is a 4-cylinder engine. If you have 4, 6, 8 cylinder, the procedure will be very similar guys. Now this one guys, okay, on 4 cylinders things are a little bit more complicated, because okay, you have only, most of the times you have two variable timing solenoids, one on the exhaust side, one on the intake. If you have a V6 or V8 engines, it's like having, okay, two 4-cylinders side by side. So it may take a little bit of time to figure out exactly which solenoid it is, but you'll say bank 1, bank 2, so you will know for sure, okay, which side is which. We have a video how to know which side is bank 1, bank 2, check it out. However, now guys, okay, on a 4-cylinder engine, things are super easy. Now, why it says B camshaft position sensor? Because guys, okay, this is on the exhaust side. Intake side stands for A. Why? Because the way the things happen in order, guys. Engine first gets air and fuel, and then it burns and it comes out of the exhaust. That's why it's B. So looking at the car now right here, guys, it will be this solenoid, okay, right there, that variable timing solenoid. We're going to pull that white thing, yellow thing, push down and disconnect it. Now if you need to replace it, guys, it has one bolt, okay, there that you need to remove. I'm trying to focus. And you pull it out. We have a video on the channel that explains how to replace a VVT solenoid. Check it out. We demonstrated on Chevy Cruze. And pretty simple, okay, but a few things that you need to know and how not to contaminate anything, because otherwise it may not function. So what we are going to do, we'll go ahead and replace ours. The purpose of today's video is to see if new solenoid will fix that and see if everything goes away, that those codes and that engine light. So if you need any tools and you need to get a new solenoid, check out the description below and you can find the link where we buy everything for our vehicles from. So the solenoid has been replaced. Okay, that VVT solenoid. I'm going to go ahead, turn the ignition on now. Okay, ignition is on. We're going to go back and I'm going to click erase codes. Perfect, erase done. I'll go ahead start the car now. Engine light is not on. I'll go ahead and read the codes. I'll recommend to read the codes only with ignition on, car not running, but I'll go ahead and do that. No pending codes, guys. So that definitely fixed our problem so far. If you guys have any questions, please leave a comment, guys. We'll try our best to make a video for your problem. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and see you guys next time.